Birthday. It's just a little bit after lunchtime now.
Manly already had his lunch though, and it is on his face a little bit.
You ready to go get cleaned up? They gave you your lunch before I changed your clothes. What are we gonna do?
I already changed my clothes. Hey!
Say hey everybody, I got jelly on my forehead.
I'm gonna go get him cleaned up real quick. We're gonna make the tacos for lunch, and then we're gonna have pizzas when everybody else gets here later this evening. But Jacob is ready for some tacos, so that's gonna be lunch. All right, y'all, I got Manly changed. Me and Jonah are bringing the rolly desk chair back up here into the living room. I brought it in here the other day and Titus thought the kids brought it in here. And so he took it back to the bedroom and I was like, no, I brought it in here. So yeah, I'm gonna be the one cooking the steak for these tacos. We say tacos, fajitas, tacos. We can go into great detail. We're making steak and we're gonna put it inside of a tortilla shell. These happen to be the fajita size ones too. But yeah, Titus normally cooks the steak for these because he can cook steak better than me. But he had some stuff he needed to do this afternoon, so I told him I will cook the steak for Jacob's steak, taco, fajita things. First, I have to make some sweet tea, and a lot of y'all have asked if I would tell how I make our sweet tea. I used to have a video, it was like 15 minutes long, on how to make sweet tea, for real. I talked about it for 15 minutes. I talked a lot slower back, way back then. It was like 4 years ago. So here's the quick version of that video. It does get a little complicated with sweet tea, especially if you've never made it before. When you first make it, it tastes bad. It really does. I do not like tea. When I very first make it, I don't like the way it tastes. You have to let it sit for a little while. And I think that's what a lot of people, when they first make their tea and then they drink it, they're like, I don't like it. I can't make it right. It has to sit for a little while. Titus, now he likes it when I very first make it. He'll drink a glass of it right then and he likes it. I don't. It's bitter. It's kind of bitter. I don't know what else to say. It's just, it's not good when you very first make it. To me, like I said, Titus likes it. But anyway, Great Value tea bags are the ones we use. We like Great Value, Louisiane, Tetley, and Lipton in that order. Yeah, Great Value is the one we like the best. So anyway, I use two bags, two of the family size bags. I just fill my pot, this size pot. I'm using my other one right now, but I fill it up almost to the top, like leave about 2 inches from the top maybe. And then I put in two tea bags and I turn it on high. So the tea bags stay in there until it comes to a boil. When it comes to a boil, I turn it off and then I let it just completely stop boiling. Now comes the sugar part. How much sugar do you put? That also depends on when you're gonna be drinking this tea. If you're gonna be drinking it right away, you're gonna need a little more sugar if you want it to taste like, you know, sweet tea. Because at first, you're not even gonna taste that sugar. If you put just a little bit, you're not gonna taste it at all at first. Tea gets sweeter the longer it sits. So if I'm making sweet tea for right then, we're gonna be drinking it right then, I put a little more sugar than I would normally put. But if I'm making it for the next day, then I do not put as much sugar. And that depends on how sweet you like your tea, how much sugar you're gonna put. For us, say if I was making this tea right now for supper tomorrow, if I'm making it a full 24 hours ahead of time, a half a cup of sugar would be good. Back in that old video, we used to put more sugar in our sweet tea too back then, 4 years ago. I can't remember how much it was, but we used to put more back then. But now, if I was making this tea for tomorrow evening for supper, a half a cup of sugar would be fine because it would be sitting for a full 24 hours. And like I said, the longer it sits, the sweeter it gets. So it's gonna be sweet enough, it'll be just right 24 hours from now. This tea, we'll be drinking this tonight for supper. So I'm gonna put a cup of sugar because we'll be drinking it in just probably 3 hours or so. And at first, when you first make it, it's gonna taste like there's no sugar in it. That's why I think a lot of people, I might have already said this, I think that's why a lot of people are like, I don't even like my sweet tea when I make it. If you drink it right away, like I said, it's bitter. Yeah, I did already talk about it. Anyway, so yeah, you just gotta test it out and see how much sugar you and your family like. But definitely make the tea ahead of time. Like if you want it for supper that night, at least make it that morning so that it has time to sit because it's gonna taste a lot better then. When it completely stops boiling, then I put it into the, I'm gonna make it in this today. I put the sugar in here, pour in the hot tea, it melts the sugar. and then I just add cold water all the way to the top. We have well water, so I use our well water because it tastes good. But when we've had city water in the past, I didn't use the city water because sometimes it tastes really bad. I would just get drinking water from Walmart and use those to make the tea with because the city water was just really not good. And sometimes when I add the cold water, I also put in a little bit of ice. I don't do that all the time, but I do it sometimes. That's the short version, and it was probably still a little bit long. You gotta give the details. You gotta give the sweet tea details because, yeah, I can see where if you've never had sweet tea before and you make it and drink it right then and you're like, no, that's gross. I can see that. I can see that happening. You gotta let that stuff sit for a little while. So I've got some oil heating up in the skillet over here. I'm gonna go ahead and season these steaks. I'm using thin cut ribeye today because I had these in the freezer, but normally I use like a sirloin steak. I found some seasoning that we're going to use. Steak and chop. Should we use that or should we find something else? Y'all, I am so sorry that door hit y'all in the face like that. Okay, I'm going to decide between these two. Atkins ranch style steak seasoning and Weber steak and chop seasoning. I'm going to smell them and see which one I like the smell of the best. And that's the one we're going to use. Okay. They kind of smell the same. We'll go with the Weber. Okay, I'm gonna turn the skillet down and get my onions and peppers ready over here. Jonah's over here eating the onions. He is just like me. We can just eat onion right by itself. I don't like the way it makes my breath taste or smell after, but it's worth it.
Yeah, I like to brush your teeth.
Yeah, but most of the time brushing your teeth don't help. I've found a few things over the years, like if you eat a hot pepper, right behind after you eat onions, that takes the onion smell away. I guess it burns it out. Okay, I'm gonna put just a little bit of the steak seasoning on the peppers and onions here. Once these start to get really tender, I'll take them out and put the steaks in. Are you X's or O's, Sissy?
X.
Okay. Finished eating, and all the kids said that my steak taco thingies were better than Titus's. I think they were just being nice, but still, they said it. I did kind of copy how he makes it, and those were better than any other that I've ever tried to cook on the stovetop, so. All right, I'm gonna get the kitchen cleaned up, and then the bathrooms, and then it'll be close to time for everybody to be getting here to celebrate 16 years of Jacob. Time flies, people. Time flies. Just yesterday, I could pick him up and hold him. It happens too fast.
Can you stay little for Mama?
Yeah.
Wow. You're gonna grow up on me too, aren't you?
I still remember the day that you came. You were so little. For me, it's just a day. Now you're all grown up, tall as a tree, strong as a wolf pup, faster than me. So if you're worried that a chance will pass you by, standing on the sidelines wondering why. What's the worst thing that could happen if you tried? Well, you might fall.
Two pepperoni, two cheese, two extra most bestest.
It's gonna be a fine day today, I can see. It's gonna be a fine day today, I can see. It's gonna be a fine day today for you and me. It's gonna be a fine day today, just wait and see.
See you tomorrow.
It's gonna be a fine day today for you and me.